We got some green base over this purple, and we are, this is all going to get some crazy skulls in here, but I wanted to get some background work done, so that when we put the skulls over the top of this, this is all in the background. Sorry we didn't get the other stuff being done, but we'll take the camera off and go around and show you what it looks like, and then we'll show you after we pull the mask off. But you kind of get the idea there. This is a metal flake lime green. You can't see the metal flake because it's base coat and it's dry, and base coat dries flat. But once it's up, once clear goes on it, that makes the whole thing come out. So here in a minute, we're gonna start unmasking this.
That's what it looks like.
Yeah,
that's right.
That really
looks good.
Yeah, it's just stuff that I don't have to do after I'm working on the skull, so.
I like it.
This way,
I can't wait to see how that purple hits on that green. That's gonna look sharp.
Yeah.
I was kind of, you know, throwing my hands up a little bit on that green, but man, once you highlighted it,
yeah,
it flows right with it. Pretty cool. Freaking time.
I'm liking that little bit of underspray from the airbrush.
Mm-hmm.
It's hard to tell. I'll turn it around. This edge between where the black shading is, I wanted it to show up a little bit because I may peel the metal back and make it look like the metal's actually peeled back a little bit. I hadn't decided on that yet. But I'm liking the way that green kind of glows behind that black airbrush a little bit. And it's actually adding to the to what I was working on, so. Like Bob Ross says, it's a happy accident. I kind of expected it though. I was debating on how much I'm gonna have to go around the edge with this with the airbrush, but to be honest, you see that little bit of underglow from that green?
I like that.
I kind of think that's gonna separate that from that purple. I'm almost tempted to probably leave that the way it is.
I like the way that looks. Look how it did it up here.
Yeah, it did it almost all the way around because of this paper that I was using for mask. I mean, we could have used a different paper, but I was kind of hoping for this effect.
I like it because it looks like the metal's peeled.
Because I don't know. I was thinking I was going to have to come around this and highlight this edge with the airbrush, you know, in places. But with that green popping out, it almost works like a highlight itself, so. I'm not disappointed in the way it come out, to be honest. I kind of like the effect, so. This is going to be one of those things where I will have to do a little bit of cleanup here or there, of course, because no matter how good you mask something, something's always coming out in it. Trying to see what I'm doing, if you can see. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that glow.
I think it looks pretty awesome like that.
There's a spot I'm gonna have to touch up where the paint got under the paper. I'll show you how we do that. This is purple with a base of clear over it, a couple of coats of clear. Because if I make any mistakes over clear, I can just scuff it off and go back. So yeah, it got under the paper over there.
Yeah. Yeah, people don't realize how much time it takes to mask these things off. Yeah. I love this one tear on this side on this bottom.
I know.
And just that one spot, really set that off.
See, we got some overspray here. I can wipe most of that off, but if I hit that with clear, if I just wipe this and grab me the wet sand bucket with the 1500, I think it's out there. If I just wipe that off, chances are as soon as I clear that, it's gonna show back up. So usually once I go around and do any cleanup on the edges,
what I'm doing now is a little bit of this overspray. I don't wanna take it all off because I want this green to look like it's
coming out over the tank. I want this black to kind of look like that's the edge of this tear. And this is how I remove overspray. 1500, a little bit of wet. And it won't hurt to get this base coat wet. In fact, I'm gonna show you a new trick with this. Not a new trick. If you're a painter, you probably already know this, but for all you guys that are learning, this will be a cool way to inspect your work. Basically, when I get done airbrushing something and I want to see how it looks under clear, there's one quick way of doing that. Like this green, you can't tell any metal flakes in it at all. And this won't hurt it. Just let the water dry and then wipe it gently. But what I'll do is I'll take and pour water over it, and you can see what it's going to look like under the clear that way. It won't hurt anything, and with base coat, you can see how the water doesn't want to attach itself to it, and it'll wipe right off. Now, these are Scott, S-C-O-T-T, blue towels. Scott makes a couple different blue towels. These are paint safe. The ones that aren't look like they got a dark blue woven line into them. They kind of look almost plaid. Don't use those on paint. They will screw up your paint job. This stuff right here is, I've used it for years. I don't have any problems with it. It's paint safe. You can wipe it over gently over anything. Dry stuff nicely. Even after you've sanded and buffed your clear coat and all the clear is done and the bike's done and you're ready to go out the door, if you take one of those other blue towels and roll over that artwork with some wax, or over the clear coat with some wax, it will scratch the living tar out of that fresh clear coat. These are paint safe. I absolutely guarantee if you use these, they won't cause you a problem with your clear coat. And then a couple weeks later down the road, you know, then that clear can be waxed with anything. But I would make sure to get these. They don't look like they got anything woven in them, and they will not scratch your clear. What I'm doing now is I'm gonna come off these hard edges, and I'm just gonna crack into this purple a little bit, just to kind of make this look like it's not just put on there, so. Almost as if this is bleeding into that purple. That looks real cool. Do like that. See how that sets that crack down into that?
And I don't want this these cracks to stand out a bunch on this purple. I don't want that purple to just show through. What do you think?
Fire.
Yeah, I really like it. Now it's starting to attach itself.
It looks better.
I was looking for that attachment. It looked like just it was sticking on there. Of course, with clear, it makes a big difference. But I was looking on this attachment. I wanted to make sure that this looked like it was attached to this. The rip was actually attached to the fender, you know. And I'm taking that underglow off as I put these cracks into the purple, right at the point where they come in. Because I want that part to look deeper than this kind of turned up peel. As I say in the airbrush field, when you're airbrushing cracks, the best thing to do is get back at it like a crack addict, because the more you shake, the better they look. This is the one time with an airbrush you can just have the jitters. If you want to do really good cracks, I found if you smoke a cigarette right before you do this, you'll get really good little tiny shakes out of that deal. You probably don't want to smoke a cigarette if you're trying to do detail work, but if you're doing cracks and stuff, get a good old Camel wide and have at it, because it will it'll give you a shake just enough to get all that into this. I'm thinking that looks pretty good. Tell me when it's too much, Ryan.
Once you get there.
I'm loving it.
I think that looks good.
I'm loving it. When those skulls get in there,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, awesome. Couple of little spots that I didn't like, but
looks really good.
Yeah, I think we're good there. I didn't think I was going to do anything like this on this, but
I like it.
To be honest, I love the cracks in it. It
throws it together.
Yeah, it's just making everything come to life. If I need to, I can take a little bit of white and just touch a few highlights, but I think that's almost going to be too much.
You know what, if anything, if you did that, I would use the green.
Yeah.
That might look like it's peeling out of everywhere.
That could work.
It's hard to see on the camera.
Yeah.
When that clear hits it, it won't be.
Think about doing a crack. You leave that highlight, it doesn't work. You gotta kind of bleed that crack through that highlight and drag it out. I'm loving it, especially between the two, the way they're both coming together.
It almost looks veiny.
It's kind of hard, because with these colors, you want to go alien stuff. I almost should put alien skulls in this, but
that's not what he wanted. But I don't know, I may have to send him a picture and find out if he wants to do some alien skulls instead of regular skulls. Pull that one out where that little bit of overspray come out. Can you see, or am I pulling it away from the camera. Sometimes it won't hurt just put a little bit of black in these areas, just to kind of drag them a little deeper into the deal. Sometimes, you know me, I don't never make a full decision on what I'm doing until I'm doing it. Once I get to working on it, it just kind of comes as we work along.
And you just see what it's looking like and how you can improve it.
And, you know, I got an idea in my head of what's going to be done, but until I get to working on it, I don't really make any hard decisions on what I'm going to do or what I'm not going to do until it kind of comes together on the palette. Oh, I'm loving that.
Yeah, that looks sick.
Can you see the way it's coming together?
Not real good unless I get
here. Come over here and go ahead and do that, and I'll work on this side a little bit.
Oh, I like that.
It's kind of hard for me to see these cracks on this purple, but when we hit it with clear.
Well, it's the same with me on the camera. You can't see it unless I get right up on it. That looks good.
I'm loving it.
That was insane.
All right, run some cracks up around the gas cap. Got this thing about too tall for me.
I get your tool.
Well, normally I don't airbrush while they're on the stand, but we've got more stuff to do while it's on the stand, so. Normally we put it over there on a bench and film it, but. Oh, I'm loving it. Loving it! Yeah, it's all coming together. And everybody, don't forget, we're going to be giving away a paint job. We're at 680 plus subscribers right now. When we hit 1,000 subscribers, we're going to go through and kind of look at who's been our most popular person on liking and commenting and all that stuff. And we're going to kind of put all the guys that have done some stuff with us throughout our start of the channel, and somebody is going to be picked randomly. We're going to make a random pick, and somebody will win a free paint job from Iron Blackbird Cycles. So be sure and subscribe. You have to be a subscriber if you want a chance at winning the paint job. And send us a message on YouTube, like and subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you'll be notified if you win. And as soon as we reach 1,000 subscribers, we are going to take all the people that's on the channel and have liked videos and have subscribed to the channel, throw them in a pile, and we are going to pick one of those people to win a free paint job from Iron Blackbird. So, and we'll do it live. And also, if you if you're thinking about getting a paint job from us, remember, you can ship us your sheet metal, give us the colors, give us the graphic ideas, we'll send you back some stuff, and then we will ship it back to you ready to go.
Bring that crank down along the side.
Well, next we will be doing the skulls. Okay, so today we're getting ready to do some skulls on this green and purple stuff. Tune you in on a little bit of airbrushing, and we'll be back as soon as we start pulling the mask, but go ahead and enjoy some airbrush. I just use this mask to dot in a quick outline, and we come back and do the detail work all freehand. This just gives me a guide to where I need to be, what I'm doing. We've got some dark forest green we're going to come in here with and probably do like the insides of the eyes for dark shadowing of the skull. ironically, the cracks that I put in the background actually work inside the skull almost just as well. That's looking pretty slick already, huh?
Mm-hmm. Looks a lot different than that big black blur that was up there.
Yeah. Feels like a piece of mask right there, but I sure can't. Ah, it is. Another piece there. You spray that black over that mask, it blends in. Feel it, because I sure as hell can't see it. Normally I don't like to run my hands all over the artwork, but only one way to find all that mask. A little bit of shading goes a long way.
to come together. Better?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's see what we got here. Got to blend all this into this other green. Gonna look pretty cool if we run those back into those cracks, I think. Thank you.
Should have thinned that up a lot on the mask. But we'll fix it.
Trying not to cover up that pretty lime green, but I think that looks pretty good, don't you? Yeah. Well, when that clear hits that, it'll have a soothe. The blacks will be black and the limes will be lime. That's going to be nice. Better. So what I'm doing is just laying in outline right at the moment, and probably putting a couple skulls in here, one facing this way, one facing the other. Filming. What, and that's what the outline looks like. Gotta go cut another skull here. Did I even hit record on that? No, okay. The outline on this skull won't look like much till I get done with it. A lot of detail in this one. I'll add all the detail with the airbrush on this one.
What are you gonna do with that spot on top?
That's all gonna be
that squared.
It's all gonna be brushed in, background, spider web, whatever. Okay. That's gone now.
Had a master of puppets, there's masters of skulls. That's cool.
Oh, look how that turned out. Shit. I'm gonna take some fucking green in there. Well, we're not gonna start this four-wheeler shit up down the fucking alley again, or I'm gonna go throw shit out there.
I think they're gonna lure the dog.
Difference just that little piece right there.
Mm-hmm.
I really highlighted that nose. It looks good.
Well,
couldn't be no better unless I did it.
Yeah, I don't think so either. It's yeah.
Once it clears out, I think it'll even look better.
Mm-hmm. I kind of like it to have that shadow.
Yeah. I am going to take some of that dark forest green and just kind of tone this down a little bit so the skulls pop a little better.
Mm-hmm. It's good.
is, everybody. We've got the purple with the green skulls. Tearing through the purple. Sorry about the colors in here. This green has a lot of pearl in it, but my paint booth lights are really bright, so kind of affects the color of that green, makes it look more creamy, but it's a lot more lime than this. Tomorrow, all this stuff gets sanded and buffed, take all paint lines out of everything, and it will be ready to put on the motorcycle. Siren Blackbird Cycles. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification button.